Hello, everybody. Thanks for tuning in, if you are. My name's Theo, and I haven't done this in a while, so bear with me. I've been playing Elite Dangerous for a couple of months now. It's actually really fun. It's a blast. And I'm currently out and about doing a bit of exploration. So I'm going to show you a bit of that. Streaming, that's why it's taking a little bit longer than it usually does to load. So there we go. Alright, what's going on? Oh, that's why. All right, there we go. You guys should be able to see now. There we go. For some reason, OBS does not like my full screen settings. Ever. Fuck OBS. No, it's a good program. It streams well too, so. Alright, here we go. I'm in a ship called an Asp Explorer. I could show you the rig and the whole setup and everything, but unfortunately, I'm out in uncharted, unexplored space at the moment, so I have to show you from here. Very basic setup for those of you who are familiar with the game. All lasers, because since I'm exploring, I'm not going to have an opportunity to stop at a station anywhere to reload ammunition for missiles and stuff like that. So, and you can synthesize things, of course, but kept it very basic. The advanced discovery scanner, of course, you need. Hopping from system to system. Detailed surface scanner for each planet that I'm scanning and identifying. Of course, the 5A power plant. Big fuel scoop, because of course you can't stop at stations to refuel when you're exploring, so you gotta capture your fuel from the sun. Or whatever, sun, star, whatever the heck you want to call them. Biggest frame shift drive. Of course, planetary vehicle hangar, so, and with the SRV. So when I actually land on a planet, I can drive around and take a look. The other thing, of course, is synthesizing. You can collect materials on planet surfaces and create munitions, small caliber, high velocity, large, whatever. Can't repair and refuel my SRV at the moment. I'd have to get some more stuff, but it's all available on planet materials. Alright. Let's open up the galaxy map and show you where I'm going, what I'm doing. Do here is zoom out. This is where I'm at currently. Going back here. This would be the home systems. Where I'm actually based at. And as you can see, I'm quite a bit of distance away. Where I was, and it's currently where I'm heading. You can only plot routes up to 1,000 light years at a time, and I can show you where I'm heading to. You see this little cloud of dust out here. It's called the Lagoon Nebula. Once I get in there, let's see, it's over 2,816 light years from where I am currently, and that's not even inside the nebula. That's just right about the beginning of the sector. Going inside the nebula, there's kinds of things to see. But that would be en route to the core of our galaxy. Sagittarius A is where I'll eventually be heading to. But, Thirty-five jumps to M20. This is where my next stop is. Once I get there. Now, along the way, I'll be stopping and scanning planets, which I'll show you. This is my current route. The system we're in right now. There are a few unexplored planets here. Let me open up the system map and I'll show you exactly what it looks like. There's nothing landable, so of course none of these have been discovered yet. It's in Universal Cartographics. Actually have a chance to have your name in gold if you are the first to have discovered the system and explored each one of the orbital bodies within it, which is pretty cool. But there's no landable planets in here, so I'm not even going to bother with it. Current system. So let's get going. Maximum jump range is about 32 and some change light years from system to system. So the average jump's been between 30 and 31. So let's get going. Let's jump into the next system.
Frameshift drive charging.
Be a short video, a little bit of an intro, kind of show you exactly what I'm doing in the game. And what the game's about. Turn the game volume down a little bit so you can hear me. Scoop automatically deploys. Fuel that way. There you go. You saw the little message pop up here in the corner underneath the info. Told me I discovered one new orbital body. I used my discovery scanner to see how many more are in this system. Only one. Right. This is my next destination right here. Take a look and see what's in the system. Just two stars. Here's the little gold thing I was telling you about. First discovered by whoever the hell this person is. And I'll be stopping to scan and explore each one of these orbital bodies in the systems that I jump to that haven't been discovered yet. But I will scan the star. I'm sorry, drying clothes. I am gonna scan the star though, so that the system name comes up when I turn in the cartographics when I get to a base. Target it, turn around, and scan it. Stars scan at a pretty distance. Planetary and orbital bodies, you have to get up closer. 456 light seconds away from this one. So boom, there's the name. Pops up. I've explored this system. Go back. Reselect my destination. There is a camera system in this game, which is probably one of the best camera systems ever created in the game, period. Hands down. If you've ever been online and checked out some videos of guys who do this stuff regularly, two guys I follow are Obsidian Ant. Schumer. Schumer right now is doing an episodic series on YouTube, doing an exploration thing. Really, really great stuff. If you get a chance, check him out. But camera system is kind of complex, and the controls I'm still getting used to. But I'll be filming my little exploration exploits myself and then posting them to the YouTube channel, which I've connected to this Twitch channel. And if you care to watch them, you can later on once I post them. But if I find anything particularly of interest to see, I'll record videos of it using the camera system. So you guys can, whoever watches it can check it out and see how cool it is. It really is. The camera system is probably one of the best in the game, in the gaming industry right now. Any angles, all kinds of angles, following the ship, following orbital bodies, suns, whatever. You can zoom in and out, move around. It's just so crazy cool. But it is pretty complex to use. I'm still getting used to the controls, so I could probably do a little quick demo since we're in a pretty empty system here. Jump to it. That's me. Look at me, old fart. Different views. This is a really cool view. You can still control the ship in the camera views, which is really cool. But you can do all kinds of cinematics. You can set the camera free, move around. That's the part where I can't control yet. I'm still trying to get used to the controls doing that. So. You can catch my YouTube videos later on, but like I said, I'm only going to do that if I find anything really cool and interesting and different. Let's jump to the next system.
Crew ship drive charging.
So for some people, exploration might be kind of boring, but you never know what you're going to run into out here. That's what makes it interesting. Just another sun. Oh, and this system has yet to have been discovered because there's no gold name underneath it. Cool. If I get to a station and sell my cartographics, my name will be up on this one. So, go back here. Scan this so we get the name, type, and everything. Yellow orange star, class K. Other orbital body. so. It's pretty far away, but it shouldn't take too long, 35,000 light seconds. See the little timer here. It's going down. That's how long it's going to take to get there. It'll jump up pretty fast here in a minute. I can play around with the camera while we're waiting for this. Enter a free camera. Speed. Forgetting how to do this. Out how the heck to get this camera to stay stationary. Whatever. Damn, this thing's been scanning. Fuck. Huh. second now. I think the stars generally scan within 5,000 light seconds. This is going pretty quick. Got about another minute here. Like I said, the only reason I'm doing this is just in case somebody doesn't discover it and get back to a station before I do. I get my name on it in shiny gold letters. Yay! Yay me. Occasion the discovery scanner, even though it's advanced, won't catch everything on the first scan, so sometimes you hit it again in the system and something will pop up. But there's nothing out here except these two suns. So that's it. Got them both. Gives you the breakdown, solar mass, surface temp, orbital period. Pretty cool stuff. But anyway, reselect the next jump spot. You see right off here in the distance, just to the right of where this OQ-I letters are, just above it. See, that's the Lagoon Nebula way off in the distance. Still over 2,700 light years away. Close to 2,800 light years away. Before I get to explore that.
Frame shift drive charging.
No, jumping into the next system. Red Dwarf, I can refuel here. There's some stars you can't refuel on. There's only certain ones you can. Brown Dwarfs you can't. Our sun hasn't been discovered yet. None of these planets are landable. I'm not going to mess around with this system. There's nothing. Let me select it so I can scan it. System name. Star info in the cartographics. You get cashy money, shinies, when you sell your cartographic information at stations. So this is why you want to scan, do detailed scans of each orbital body within a system. You get more money that way, and especially if it's a planet of particular interest, such as, let's see, what do we got here? Nothing that would garner any kind of big cash. So, ammonia-based plants, which means there could possibly be life. Earth-like planets get you the most, score you the most. You can't land on surface worlds, or worlds with atmospheres, unfortunately, right now. It's something you're supposed to be doing later on in the game. And hopefully they do. So, sooner rather than later. Let's jump into the next system. See what we got there. There's something of interest. I want to at least land on a planet and show you what that's all about real quick before I close this video out.
Frameship drive charging.
Jump, another red dwarf star. Class M. Another red dwarf. I had a string of systems a few days ago that were nothing but brown dwarf stars. I can't refuel on those. I kept having to jump over to another system that was short, just so I could refuel. Bunch. None of the planets have been discovered yet. Only the first two suns. Alrighty. This one's not that far off. Let's scan this one first. Get the others. This is what the unexplored looks like. This is the other sun. These are all pretty unremarkable. They're all relatively close to one another. This one's not perfectly spherical. Neither is this one. This one's slightly bodies that aren't stars. You have to get a lot closer than 5,000 milliseconds to actually scan them. Coming in pretty close, actually. Probably under 9 milliseconds based on the size. Oh, even closer. Symbol there with the ship means it's landable. I'll show you on the system map. This is the summary. There's nobody living on it, zero population. This gives you details on it and the materials that are on the planet that you can harvest. Ooh, it has iron magma volcanism. Ooh, we're gonna have to get up and close and personal on this one, huh? There's volcanoes on this bad boy. We'll have to find one here. This may be one right here. Not perfectly spherical either. There's quite a few like this, actually. When you happen upon them, that was a big nasty strike. Look at that. This could be a volcano. I'm believe we're on the light side of it right now. This could possibly be a volcano. Let's go ahead and take a look at this sumbitch, shall we? Find a volcano. So at least there'd be something to look at. about 80, 90 some kilometers. Something remarkable here to look at. Spot over here? I don't know. It's hard to tell. It doesn't give you too much detail, unfortunately, on the planetary map. I mean, you can get a fairly good idea, but you have to actually land to see anything. Doesn't look like there's anything on this side where I'm at. Well, this is bogus. I really wanted to see a volcano. That's what I said, right? Iron magma. 67% rock, mostly rock, no metal, but iron magma. Where? Damn it, where? Oops. Okay. Try again. Out of the orbital glide.
Orbital flight engaged.
I think there's got to be some volcano down here, maybe. These channels cut into it. Something I think down here, huh? Let's take a look. This looks like a good enough spot. It's gonna be something active here on these channels. set her down and I'll show you the SUV anyway. SRV, sorry.
Landing gear deployed.
Got a new contact in the area, huh? Oh, that was kind of goofy. The mouse jumped out of the game, which fucking means you lose control. This is the direction I'm setting in. Got to remind the heads. Kind of pull over here. Let's see. Absolutely nothing out here. The ship. Thank you. ship to come back in. Set down there. Materials over here. I'm getting a pretty good signal. Alright, that's pretty much what entails landing on a planet, unless you see something really cool. I was hoping to find some volcanic activity, but not seeing anything. It's crazy. I'm on the light side too. Thought maybe the sun would trigger it, I guess not. Oh well. Well, that's going to be about it for this video. I'm going to hop back in here and get back on course. Let me see about repairing this fucking thing first. Let's see. Inventory. Synthesis. Oh, what am I missing? Nothing. Back to 100%. All good. Oh. And we can get back on board the ship. There we go. Well, that was all kinds of boring. Sorry for that. Hoping to see some volcanic action down here on the planet. Sun. This would be brown dwarf. Hey, that's going to be the end of this video. Sorry it was so unremarkable. Kind of blue, actually. I'm thinking about it, but... Well, you got to see me land on a planet and scan a couple. And let's see, what's the next system here? Let's point in that general direction before I close out the game. That's going to be it for this video. Thanks for watching. And, maybe next time I'll have something a hell of a lot more remarkable to see. And, I'll have the camera controls a little better figured out than I did before. So hopefully you enjoy, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.